Tara is busy working tonight. So graciously, Petros Ioannou decided to join us here tonight. Petros works on a very, very good web series called My Life as a Video Game. I've shown you a little bit of it before. You're working right now on episode 9, correct?
9, 10, and 11, because we kind of divided it up into story arcs, and we don't really release them until all three episodes of the of that story arc is ready. The original idea, basically, was to release them all kind of like 1 week after another, or one every two weeks. And that kind of happened for the first, like, 8 episodes. And then we ran into about 60 days worth of rendering.
Yeah, tell them exactly. I saw you posed this the other day. How many processors are working right now?
If we're going by number of cores, we have 112 core.
That's a $2,000 processor right there.
Yeah. We have 112 core, 48 cores, and six quad cores.
All rendering
about 5 minutes of footage in total.
5 minutes of footage. So you are officially not
because
it
is
around. Actually
because the thing is rendering out all in full 3D in 1080, but then in 4K, but then has to be taken into After Effects, do the composition, and then re-export it as 1080. So it's like.
Which is officially not fucking around when it comes to making video.
Yeah, pretty much.
I mean, I think I'm badass because I make my 6-core chug a little bit rendering an episode, but I haven't gone quite so crazy. That's a lot of computers.
Yeah, well, there is my laptop itself is a quad core, which as Nash will remember from Con Bravo, tends to melt down. It's having an overheating problem, like with some kind of.
I need to catch up with you in London before New Year's and fix that shit for you, dude.
Oh, please do, man! Please do. I just got myself a second monitor for it as well, so I don't know how much that's gonna kill it as well. I mean, I've been using this SD monitor behind me that I had from like 2003. As a second screen to do any like effects or stuff. I've been doing some effects for a video for Brent. That's Brent Ofloss, who, if you guys have heard of him or need to see some of his other stuff, he does some awesome video game with lyrics stuff.
Yes, he does.
He's doing a very, very big one coming this Christmas, which I can't say because he would actually probably have a sniper rifle trained on me right now from New York.
All right, so. Are you ready to do the news with us tonight? Because we've got a collection. We've got some festive holiday stuff happening.
Okay, let's do festive holiday stuff.
Yeah, I say that, but it's in a horrible way because most of the stuff on my show is about horrible things like that happening. Get the intro ready and hope things don't burst. Have you heard how I have this set up running right now? I'm remoting into a computer in Illinois.
I don't know why it suddenly occurred. Like we've been speaking all week about you being in Manchester. Only just now did it occur to me on the stream that you're actually in Manchester.
Yep.
So all your gear must be back in.
Yep. So I am remoting it. I'm connecting my. What they're seeing on the screen is a Skype call from me. I'm remotely controlling the computer back there to make all this shit work. I'm not a sane person. But it does somehow function. I'm not quite sure, but it does somehow function. Let me fire up the
That's
intro.
That's kind of like my brain.
I'm going to fire up the intro here. Each week, Catherine and the Radio Dead Air audience go out on the worldwide interwebs and all sorts of horrible shit. Bring it back here for a little segment we like to call What the Fuck Is Wrong With You? And this is our Chris Quanzonica's Dismiss episode, because I cover all the holidays, make everybody pissed off equally that way.
Fair enough, yeah. It makes sense to have someone like me helping out with a section called What the Fuck Is Wrong With You, because of that it pretty much just sums up why I tried to do this series. There's something wrong with me.
Yeah, when we get into doing the stuff and all the time that goes into it, whatnot, we just have to stop and go, really, dude?
All for, like, I kind of like look at some of like the like some of my friends like in the larger YouTube community who are like doing like videos that like take, with all due respect to them, a day to shoot and edit, and I'm spending, and they can like crank those out like 3-4 times a week, and I'm spending literally thousands of dollars,
yep,
and weeks of time.
All right, I'm sending you the first story here. I you remember Elf, that Will Ferris film?
Yeah.
That was a cute movie, wasn't it?
Actually, I found it really disturbing, but
well, we have a version now, I guess, for the times. Man dressed as Elf charged with DUI, because of course he was. Let's see here. A man dressed as one of Santa's little helpers found himself in trouble Friday morning when Riverdale police allegedly discovered him drunkenly passed out in a car around 3:30 a.m. Sergeant Pat Harden was dispatched to the parking lot of Target on Route 23 after receiving a report of a suspicious vehicle. Harden located the car, a gray Toyota van parked in the store's loading dock with its engine running, lights on, and music blaring. The driver, Brian Chalice, 23, was asleep behind the wheel wearing an Elf on the Shelf costume. After shutting off the car's engine and waking Chalice, the sergeant detected a strong odor of alcoholic beverage on his breath. Harden further observed that Chalice seemed confused over his whereabouts, had an open can of beer inside of the car. Because, yeah, if you wake up drunk in an Elf costume behind the wheel, you're going to be a little bit confused, I think.
I have woken up drunk in other countries before, but never in an Elf costume. Like, I've woken up in Swansea and in Scotland on two separate occasions.
Well, Swansea was probably quite a dull. It was like, oh, Swansea. Okay, but Scotland, you have to be in a little bit of fear of your life at that point.
Scotland, I was already all the way up in Leeds. So, like, I just got on the train that went the wrong way and fell asleep and woke. And I was so drunk, I didn't even remember getting off the train and passing out on a bench. But with Swansea, that actually kind of was pretty bland. It once again was a falling asleep on the train thing and waking up and just missing my stop and ended up on the other side of the country.
Swansea is sort of where beige goes to die, if you don't know at home. That's one of those things. I understand it. What you have to understand, at some point, this guy actively made the decision, right, tonight I'm going out to drink, but to do so, I'm getting my Elf costume on.
I mean, it's one thing to dress up in a fancy dress and, like, you know, go out dressed as Batman, or, you know, go out dressed as, like, Super Mario or something like that. And, like, you know, go out drinking with your friends. Elf on a Shelf is not the kind of first costume I choose, I'll be honest, for a fancy dress party. I'd sooner go out painted green as the Hulk.
Yes.
Which my brother did do one time, and got beaten up by bouncers. But it's what happens when you show up to a club half naked. In your underpants. But
Elf on a Shelf, because, you know, nothing quite says it's time to get toe up like jingly little curly shoes. Oh, and people in the channel are like, drunken bastard, Santa laid me off, fucker.
I was just discussing earlier with my mother, of all people, a tale of how I got very, accidentally got very high in Vegas. Well, I do mean accidentally this time, because Vegas, but Vegas was just happened to be the location. I had a toothache on my 24th birthday. I was in Vegas. First ever time I went to Vegas. And I went and got some Ambisol, which we don't have in the UK, from a store. And the instructions on it say, take orally. Now, if something says take orally, what's your first thing you think of? You think ingesting it, right?
Did you eat a tube of Ambisol?
It was liquid, and I drank about half a bottle of Ambisol. And kind of walked out, like my brother and my cousin were out there, walked out with them and was kind of like, hi guys, wow, Vegas is bright. Look at all the little pretty lights, wow, cool. Hi, high five.
You're never...
police officer, can you take me to the movies, please?
At that point, you're never going to feel your colon again. Everything is dead inside forever.
I actually, that's not a joke. I actually asked the police officer, excuse me, Mr. Police Officer, could you take me to the boobies, please? I was in Vegas. I'm pretty sure I wanted to go to a strip club or something, but like, I have no recollection of this. But the point is, I'm pretty sure this police officer, this was not the worst thing that police officer had even seen that day.
Probably not. It's Vegas.
Like that hour.
What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas, and the police have to deal with it.
But what happens in Cedar Grove, or wherever this guy was, where was he?
Riverdale. Yeah. New Jersey. Riverdale.
This makes perfect sense. It was New Jersey.
But, you know, of course, it is the holiday season, and we have to remember the reason for the season, which is... It's the birth of our savior, except, you know, when he shows up naked and tries to burn the house of worship down. Let me send you this story. Naked arsonist claiming to be Jesus sets church on fire. Roswell, Georgia. Roswell passed.
On fire. Well, of course.
Roswell pastor spoke out after a man who was found naked allegedly set his church on fire. Police arrested Juan Ramirez. Juan Ramirez? It's the guy from Highlander.
Hello.
Lobos Ramirez.
You know what? I can see Sean Connery doing that, actually.
I'm Sean fucking Connery. I just burned down a church.
I decided to burn my church down.
Oh, you know what else? I'm fucking Jesus. The hell are you going to do about it? I'm Sean fucking Connery. Found him naked near the church after Ramirez admitted to setting the church on fire. According to the incident report, authorities responded and were told a man was naked. Authorities found the man, identified as Ramirez, and said he told them he was trying to get in touch with Indian gods. Ramirez says he is Jesus Christ, but Father Philip Scott thinks he's far from it. Yeah, that's kind of hard to go. Nah, that
I'm
guy.
Jesus, and I've decided to burn down my church because I'm searching for Indian gods.
Again, this does sound like something Sean Connery would do.
This does sound like the sort of insane thing you would read in the paper one day that says Sean Connery burns down church because he thinks he's Jesus.
That pretty much should be all right. If you're about to do anything in life, and you have to ask yourself, "Am I in fact the Lord Jesus Christ?" The answer should always be no.
I say that frequently on Tuesday.
If you have to ask that question, you're probably not in a very good situation. It's time to have a nice, maybe sit down, have some juice, get some electrolytes back.
And this is coming from a guy with a beard, with the beard and the long hair, guys. So, you know, like, if he looks into the mirror in the morning, he doesn't say, "Jesus Christ." You know, like, that's saying something.
One of the people in the channel, liar, liar, church on fire. that's not...
Now I'm suddenly imagining Jim Carrey burning a church down. Once again, does not seem that far-fetched.
What else are they saying here? You can't fight on holy ground! This is what happens. This is what happens when immortals fight on holy ground. The church goes up in flames. It makes perfect sense now. Thing on this ridiculous
I'm
show.
Going to go burn my church down now.
You've got the fucking sword. Why do you have the fucking sword?
I got it when I was like 13. It's actually the one from the series, actually. It's the dragon head rather than the lion head.
So,
this is my place in London. If you see my garage in LA, it's like filled with all kinds of trinkets and insane shit.
So, have you ever gone on a school trip with, like, the teacher gets everyone together and they go out for something or other? I don't really, is that a UK thing? Do they do school trips here? Normally the teacher is pretty much in charge of and responsible for the safety of all involved, which is probably why this one lost her job. Let me send you the story here. Teacher fired after making a snack run, driving with 11 children in her car, two in the trunk. That's 13 kids in. Middle school teacher Heather Cagle was fired on Wednesday after piling a group of students in her car for a, quote, snack run. Cagle was a yearbook and math teacher at Catoosa Public Schools for 10 years. She just wanted to do, quote, something sweet for her journalism students and take them to Walmart for snacks. Already, that's kind of a low bar right there.
Yeah, well, when you take a bit of Walmart in the first place, there's probably not like a lot of sanity left in you.
She drove 1 mile from the school, placed two students in the front seat, seven in the back, and two in the trunk of her Honda Accord.
That's at least a big one, right?
No, it's not. The Honda Accord, it's not. Well, okay, in England, I guess you'd consider that an SUV, but it's not a very big car.
It's not like a Civic. It's not like a sedan, is it?
No, it's not.
No, it's more like the cars with the long
It's
asses.
a four door. It's a four door. 13 kids. At what point do you make two trips? For fuck's sake, make two, make three. Don't put all the fucking kids in the fucking car.
I'm just imagining, like, okay, so I'm guessing everyone's sitting on each other's lap. Let's just imagine that for a sec.
These are middle school kids, so that's already, there's going to be some fun with boners already.
Another middle school.
Middle school is 12 to 14.
Thank you. I was kind of trying to work that age out in my head.
Yeah, that's about the 12 to 14, 15-year-old range. Well, 15, you should be in high school by then, but JoJo Extreme. The magic school bus really went downhill.
I managed to fit seven people in my Renault Megane convertible, but that was with the top down, so it was quite easy to fit people in. And one of those seven people was me, so.
Yeah, but yeah, that's the kind of shit you do in college. That's the kind of shit where you're not physically responsible because you're an asshole kid. That's the shit you do.
Well, to be fair, I was 26. It was like about 3 weeks ago. It was like, okay, my school had its like 50th anniversary kind of thing, so it was basically a gigantic reunion for anyone who ever went to school, and we all decided to go to the pub after it finished at 1 in the morning, and we're just kind of like, why should we take two trips? It's like a 20-minute drive. Let's just put the top down and hope for the best. There's not going to be any cops out.
So
There were no cops out, fortunately. We ended up being okay.
I have to wonder if one of those smart asses with a cell phone, when the car stopped and they opened the door to let everybody out, if he put on, because that's a moment you've got to take. Also, you put two of them in the trunk. These are middle school kids. You put them in a dark, isolated space. Either fighting or fucking is going to happen. This is inevitable. This
You had a
is
very different middle school to me.
America. Kind of is kind of fucked up. America is kind of fucked up.
Mean, there was like, stuff going on. I don't think maybe we had sex until about 15, 14, 15.
Someone pointed out, yeah, journalism students. Hey, it's their first involvement with being in an article. So they're getting actual journalism experience from this, at least.
Yeah, bit of press or any publicity is good. publicity.
All right, let's see what else happened. Okay, so we've been having, this is like the third week in a row this has happened. Weird shit has been going on Chinese airlines. They had a fight on one with like scalding hot coffee was thrown. And another one, when the plane landed, the guy who wanted to get off the plane faster than everybody else set off the emergency exit and just got down. Well, this week, an all-out brawl. Let me send you this one. Oh, Jesus fucking Christ. This happened in the plane, in the air. A crying baby sets off mid-flight brawl between Air China passengers. Now, I've been stuck in a plane with a baby, and it's pissed me off, but not to the point of starting, you know, a Royal Rumble.
No, I just used it if I get pissed off by a baby, I just put it out the window.
Three women aboard an Air China flight to Hong Kong Wednesday got into a raucous fight over a crying baby, prompting the pilot to threaten an emergency landing. He literally had to say, if you don't stop, I'm going to turn this plane around. Chan Wong Sung was traveling with her baby when the child started to cry, awakening two passengers seated in front of her. The two women complained about the loud baby, reportedly reclining their seats and yelling at the mother. Situation continued to escalate until physical contact was made. One of the women hit her head on the overhead bin during the scuffle, but the flight was not broken up until flight crew stepped in, separating the feuding passengers. I was sitting right next to them, and she started telling the woman to shut the baby up. She started shouting back at them. Before I knew what was happening, she leaned over the seat and punched one of them. Then they started hitting her, and all hell broke loose. Fighting reportedly stopped for the duration of the flight, but police at Hong Kong's airport were notified after the incident landed to interview the passengers. Okay. Really? You're in the plane, and you're going to start a fight.
This is also just coming straight after someone has tried to open an emergency exit door.
Yep.
Because they wanted some fresh air.
Yeah.
On a plane.
Yeah. All right, look, I have long maintained, and I'm not a parent, but I've long maintained that taking kids on a plane already is kind of mean. Because if you're a small child, if you're like four and under, you are getting taken by adults into a long, cramped metal tube full of other adults who you don't know. Suddenly, the entire fucking thing starts shaking and tilting and moving around. Your ears start to pop, the pressure changes, you're freaking out, and make it scarier as hell. All the adults seem like nothing is going wrong. This is already...
There's a snakes on the plane in joke in there somewhere. Free cookie to someone who makes it.
This is already terrifying to children in the first place. So to put them in that environment and expect them to be quiet, that's not going to work. But I understand as a flyer, someone who travels, I have to deal with it because other people have kids. And, you know, I don't know if they just don't know how to use the condoms or what. But okay, they have the kids. I have to deal with it. Fine. I ain't going to start punching people in the plane. They don't like it when you do that. That makes them grumpy.
I question kind of why babies are even allowed on planes at times.
Yeah.
But, you know, the whole freedom thing. fucking democracy.
Democracy, yes.
I'm trying to picture it in my head, like a full-on brawl breaking out on a plane.
And it wasn't dudes either, it was women, which...
Yeah.
apparently, according to some of the other stories I read about this, one woman was picked up and kind of helicoptered. That's how she smacked her head on the overhead bin, because one of the other women just picked her up and spun her ass on a plane. When you land, you're not going where you intended to go. You're going to a little room, and you're going to have to stay in that little room.
Yeah,
for a while.
When you're on the plane, what little room do they put you in? The toilet?
It's like the timeout. You have to go in there.
You have to go in there and don't come out.
Go think about what you did. We don't
go think about that poor person who you did the bat, who you did the bane to Batman on.
Oh God! All right, let's see what else, because we have some tonight that certain stories kind of make me happy. I love certain ones. The last one tonight's one of my favorites. Let's see. Oh, the next one. And the headline's innocuous enough. Because normally when you're on drugs, or you happen to be, you know, a fan of drugs, one of the last places you want to go is, in fact, you know, a police station. But this dude, first mistake was, man arrested for allegedly sparking joint at Upper Darby Police Station. Okay, that's kind of weird, but it gets weirder. Several township maintenance workers were due for a bonus after being called upon to clean up a drug suspect's mess. It's not as if 33-year-old Carlin Higgs hasn't seen the inside of a jail cell before. He has an extensive criminal record dating back 14 years. Higgs showed up at the police station on Westchester Pike at 11:45 a.m., talking and, quote, acting crazy. Civilian security guard asked him to leave, and Higgs instead refused, sat down, and lit up a joint.
Well, if you're going to chill out, you're going to chill out. Where was this?
Upper Darby. So I believe, I'm not entirely sure where, but let's see. Maine. Oh, this is from Maine in the U.S.
Must have been some caused by Stephen King or something.
Higgs allegedly sat there and smoked his marijuana cigarette, which is already, you know, authorities believe may have been laced without PCP or something similar. So apparently they're saying he just had a joint, nothing else, just marijuana. Guard called for an officer to respond. Higgs was taken into custody, allegedly threw the joint on the floor, was taken into custody, had several rolling papers in possession. Here's where it gets really what the hell. When Higgs was placed into a holding cell, he allegedly took off all his clothes, defecated into the floor, and then smeared his feces all over the cell walls. Now, this wasn't like they went out and arrested him. This wasn't like they went and found him. This was, he showed up, blazed the doobie, started talking shit, got arrested, and then started smearing shit of his own he literally went looking for the problem.
I've seen a lot of people get high off a lot of different things.
Never saw them start finger painting with poop, did you?
As I said earlier, I've gotten so drunk I woke up in other countries, but I have never in my life seen someone decide, you know what's a good fucking idea today? I am going to shit into my hand and paint the fucking Mona Lisa on the wall.
Now, admittedly, had he actually produced the Mona Lisa from feces, I would have been, that's disgusting, but still kind of impressive. You know. Oh, the people on the channel. Well, hey, this story went to shit real fast. I mean, he actively went out to... it's not like they went and found him and arrested him and he got pissed off. No, he showed up, smoked a joint at them. I guess you call this malicious smoking a joint. With malice. at the officers till they arrested him, and then he's like, now I'm going to get naked and play. And God, do you think they don't mention if he was alone in the holding cell or not. Which is one of those things, like, you know, if it were me, and I've been picked up, you know, I've been drunk the night before or something, and I wake up in the holding cell, the guy across from me, he's pooping on the floor and drawing pretty pictures, and his penis is out. I'm never drinking again. Ever. That's like an AA pamphlet right there.
Mary Arietta, sorry if I pronounced that wrong at all, smoking a joint with intent to poop.
Jesus Christ. They're like, we have to make a new law now. What's that? Smoking joint with intent to poop? Why? You don't want to know. You don't want to fucking know. Okay? Just don't ask. It's a thing. It happened.
Much as I now curse the existence of How I Met Your Mother, there's a really funny scene in it where someone says, you've not lived until you've been, and you know all those weird signs you see sometimes and weird laws? You've not lived until you've been the reason for the creation of it.
All right, our last one, this one kind of makes me happy and sad at the same time. I like many people who are male, have an irrational fondness and amusement of monkeys. Monkeys make me laugh. They just do. I don't know why.
They're awesome.
Yeah, it's you're a dude, you like watching monkeys. Especially when monkeys try to do stuff that like humans do. And that's silly, because you're not a human monkey. You're a monkey, but you're doing human stuff. And so, you know, it's funny. Well, never let it be said that we discriminate on this show, that we only just focus on human beings with their crazy naked rampages, because this week, France, we have one of our...
of course it was the French.
One of our simian brethren had his own, and when this story broke, everybody sent it to me, because they know me. And I mean, when I say everybody sent it to me, everybody sent it to me. It's like
Spoonie, whenever a Final Fantasy story breaks.
Everybody sent it. Let's switch this back. This came to us from, I think it was Marcel. Yeah, it was Marcel. Oh, that's a picture. I've got to send you this. Monkey, police taser monkey. Primate attacks kids during chocolate-fueled rampage. No one was seriously hurt.
Chocolate-fueled rampage? Oh my god, that is insane.
It's commonplace to hear of incidents involving human suspects being subdued by a stun gun. God. However, when police taser a monkey, it makes headline news, as is this case of a chocolate-loving monkey who attacks school children during a chocolate-fueled rampage in France. A North African macaque is recovering after police showed no mercy. Oh, really? You had to go for the pun in the fucking story? When they cornered the tiny chocoholic and jolted it with a taser on Monday, reportedly the monkey had eluded police over a dozen times in the past, but officers managed to track it down after it attacked a group of kids. Law enforcement officials captured the monkey after callers claimed it was, quote, causing bedlam among residents. Before it was tased by cops, the monkey bit one of the officers who suffered minor injuries. If evidently the furry creature was hopped up on Kinder chocolate, which was given to it by locals. Police believe it was the animal's only source of food for weeks. Aw. They also believe the exotic animal was kept as a pet, which is illegal in France, was later abandoned by the owner. When it found an easy source of food, the monkey returned to the area seeking the treats, as opposed to foraging the wild where competition is stiff. So apparently, kids have been feeding the monkey chocolate, and he's okay. He's just, well, he's kind of knocked the fuck out at the point, but he's okay. Kids have been feeding the monkey chocolate, getting it hyped the fuck up, and then when they weren't giving it the chocolate, it turned on them.
Yeah, I'd do the same thing to be perfectly honest.
So if we don't give you candy, you'll turn on us?
Tom Bravo's going to be very dark this year.
And we had to tase Petros again. Nobody had any Hershey bars left. He just lost his shit.
Hershey bars, I don't sell for that shit. I'm going, I want some real stuff. We're talking Nestle.
So literally, and I've been waiting to say, to use this line. I swear to God, I've been doing this show for years. I've been, don't you know, they're going to shock the monkey. Does the monkey get hurt? Monkey. Oh my God. This is. Okay. I, as a child, if I saw a monkey, I would immediately be fascinated and want to go and get involved with the monkey. So I can't really blame the kids all that much. I'm really pissed at the guy who's like keeping the monkey and just like, you know what? I do not want the monkey anymore. Fuck the monkey. Go away, monkey. You are done here. Fuck you. And you know, he had a cigarette. He's like, fuck you, monkey. I am done with you. Be gone. You are no longer welcome in my... Fuck you, monkey. But that... Don't get a pet and then just turn it loose. I don't care. Monkey, cat, dog, what? Because shit's going to happen. It's an animal.
A monkey is not just for Christmas.
Oh.
Monkey is for a lifetime. Monkey is a man's apparently worst enemy, according to this story. Eats all your chocolate and then spazzes out on you.
I don't know, man. You had them Kinder eggs? We had to ban that shit in America. They claim it was because of toys.
I realized that. Like, I was looking around one time and I was like, my girlfriend, she used to work in a candy store in Hollywood called Sweet. They have everything there. I'm talking everything. They didn't have Kinder Surprise. And I was like, why is it not here? And I asked them, like, obviously in my English accent, they asked them, because stupid American kids kept eating the toy.
Yes!
It's like, it comes in a fucking shell!
The kids would eat the toy, and they were worried kids were going
to
choke
themselves. It's not like the toy was inside the egg, and you could accidentally eat it. Yeah, that's a lawsuit waiting to happen. But it comes in a yellow container inside the fucking shell.
No, they were scared kids were going to eat the fucking thing. We're not the smartest country, sadly.
I in the UK too.
You have to love the cops. Were called, and this monkey kept eluding them, which is even because that's some Pink Panther shit going on right there. Do you have an Inspector Clouseau on payroll, perchance? Yeah. This monkey is smarter than we thought. Fuck you, monkey. I do not want you anymore. You are not welcome. Fuck you, monkey. You know he had a cigarette. Oh, so what have we learned this week? We've learned, first off, if you a monkey is not just for Christmas. A monkey is for life. Don't release your monkey into the streets. In any sense of the term, actually, that's good advice in many senses.
Yeah, that's a pretty good metaphor. Don't release your monkey into the street. I'm going to start trying to use that in everyday conversation.
We've learned that if you really, the idea of smoking pot illegally is to elude the police, not show up on their doorstep. So if you do get arrested in their station, don't get so mad you're smearing your shit on the walls. You did it to yourself, bud. You did it. You fucking did it to yourself. We learned that other people are going to take their kids on planes. Instead of losing your shit, just maybe deal with it. Noise-canceling headphones, they work. They work, and they will keep you from getting a rectal search once the plane has landed. We've learned that journalism school and clown college are not supposed to resemble one another. They're, you know, that being, if you have 13 kids in your car and you're supposed to be teaching them about the news, you might not want to have them in the news. We've learned that Sean Connery apparently is Jesus, which surprises no one.
Of course.
And finally, you're not a hard man if you're going out dressed as the elf on the shelf. Maybe rethink
on a shelf, like I got nothing for that one.
Maybe rethink your party attire. Maybe. I'm still just amusing myself here. It's like, fuck you, monkey! You're out of my life! You betray me! Fuck you.
Well, so it's the guys I'm gonna tell me what's up.
Yeah, suddenly he's telling me what's up. What are you gonna do about it? You're tearing me apart, monkey!